If you ever been away from your main PC and you need to edit or build a Power BI report, but you don't have the desktop app? Maybe you're a Mac user and you're so sick of wrestling with virtual machines? Well, there's been a big change. As of September 2025, the Power BI service has never been better. You can now model your data in your browser. Hi everybody, I'm Anne from Adair-Major Consulting. We help businesses turn their data into insights. And today I'm going to walk you through how to build a report in Power BI just using your browser. I'm also going to show you some of my favorite tips and tricks that are included in the Power BI service as of the new release, and call out some key limitations that you need to know so you don't fall into any pitfalls. Okay, so here we are starting from fresh in the Power BI service. First things first, we need some data. Straight away, you can see a whole library of connectors. It's actually not every single one that's in the desktop yet, but absolutely all the essentials are here. For the demo, we're just going to keep it really simple, and I'm just going to grab an Excel file from my OneDrive. Power BI will connect seamlessly, and just as it would in the desktop, it's going to ask me, do I want the whole worksheet, or if I had a table already formatted, it would call that out too. We get two choices, create a report or transform the data. For now, let's just hit create a report. Here's some crucial terminology. Power BI asks us to name our semantic model. You might wonder, what's a semantic model? Well, it's just Microsoft's term for what we used to call our data model or data set. It's the heart of your report, all the tables, the relationships, and the logic. Once we name it, Power BI builds that model in the service and drops this into the report editor. This should look super familiar, but the real powerful new stuff, just one click away. Let's switch over to the model view. It opens up in read-only mode first, by default, but it's just a simple click to put us in edit mode. And now this is the game changer. For the first time, we have fully interactive data model view in the browser. You'll see that it's really mirroring what the desktop app looks like, so you should be really familiar to navigate around it. You also might be familiar with what often happens with Excel sheets, where it's just called out column one, column two, etc. Well, that's not going to work, is it? So just as we would in the desktop, you're going to be sick of hearing me say that, let's clean it up by hitting transform data. And just like that, we're inside Power Query in the browser. Again, it looks just the same. Look how similar it is. The ribbon, the applied steps, it's all here. So there's really no learning curve if you're used to using Power BI Desktop. I'll quickly promote the first row to headers. This is a really common cleanup step for Excel files that I show pretty much every new user. Next, let's make sure our columns are the right data types. I'm going to pick, for example, this date. Perfect, let's close and apply. This browser modeling experience currently only works for data you import. So if you're using Direct Lake or Direct Query model, you're not going to be able to edit the model this way, at least for now. Now, a single table isn't very useful, nor is it going to show off the data model features. So let's add a second one. I'm going to fast forward through, just going through all the same steps to import a second file. Now with our two tables loaded, I'm going to create my relationship. I'll drag my customer key from my fact table, that's the one with my numbers like sales, over to my customer key on my dimension table, which holds my descriptions. I'm really interested to know, are you using fact and dimension tables in a star schema? Or if they're new terms to you, drop a comment below. And if you're interested, I can always do a follow-up video that talks a little bit more about data modeling best practices. I promise when you model your data right, it makes everything easier. Just like here. So I've now got a one-to-many relationship created entirely in my browser. We can even edit the column properties, formatting sales as a currency, for example. You'll know if you've ever tried to do any time intelligence that you can't do that without a proper date table. So let's add one in using DAX. Power BI generates the table instantly. And just as I would in the desktop, I'm going to mark it as a day table. So all our time intelligence works correctly and we're good to go. Now, while I've been doing all of that, have you noticed what I've not been doing? Saving. That's because everything in the Power BI service is automatically saving. This is incredibly helpful, but does bring up a limitation we need to think about. That autosave feature is a double-edged sword. In Power BI Desktop, if you mess up something, you can just close a file without saving. In the service, there's no undo button for modeling changes. Once you delete a column or change a relationship, that's it done. So here's my pro tip. If you're doing something complex or experimental work, either possibly keep a PBIX backup file handy or do your work in a separate development workspace. So with our brand new browser-built model ready to go, we can jump back into that report view and start building. Let's throw sales over time into a visualization. This feature already existed before, but I don't know how many people were using it. You're still able to build a visual just as you would in the Power BI desktop. Okay, and this data is not working at all in a line chart. So if we change it over to a bar chart, much more informative. If you want to be able to make your bar charts pop, I'm going to leave a video right here. It helps you turn your boring blue bars into useful, helpful bar charts that actually tell a story. Check it out.